Hello, my name is Father Paul Wickens. I was ordained in the Archdiocese of Newark, New Jersey in 1955, and I've been a priest then, well, a little over 35 years. When I was ordained in 1955, of course, everyone said the traditional Latin Mass. At that time, there was no thought or even dream of a new Mass. In 1969, a new Mass was approved by the Vatican, and this Mass was translated into various languages, including English, and hit the United States in 1971. At that time, I began to say the new Mass, as the bishop directed it. Looking back, he didn't order it, he didn't mandate it, but he directed us to, and we began to say the new Mass. Now, I did have funny feelings about the Mass, not being, let's say, a literati or a theologian, just an ordinary parish priest. I couldn't put it seem right to me. I guess you might call it a Catholic consensus. But regardless, we said the new Mass from 1971, and then in 1983, I went back to the traditional Mass. So now this is 1991, so I went back to the traditional Mass for quite a while, and many, many priests did come back to the traditional Mass. Why? Because they saw all these changes in the Church. They saw this decline of morality, seminaries closing. I don't have to catalog all the various areas of decline of the Church, morality and doctrine, and priests leaving and nuns leaving and schools closing, and not going to confession and so forth. And we saw it as not merely a few litniks who were causing trouble or a few heretics that were causing trouble, but we saw it as being much more substantial than that. We saw that there was many, many heretics who had used their influence to get to key positions in the Church. And they were able to, one of them was Annibal Bognini, who was the author of the New Mass. And one of them, Annibal Bognini, I guess he was bishop or monsignor at the time, and he brought in this new Mass, which is the sort of the flag of this new religion that is sweeping through the Church. The flag, the banner of all these changes. And why is this new Mass inferior, let's say, to the traditional Mass? Well, because first of all, the ancient Mass, what we call the Tridentine Mass, because it was approved after the Tridentine Council that existed before it by 1,000 years. But it became the barrier against the spread of Protestantism, and Pope Pius V in 1570 said that this Mass, this Tridentine Mass as we know it, should never be changed. Every priest will have a right to say it for all time, because the doctrines of the Catholic Church are clearly expressed in the traditional Mass. In the new Mass, there's a lot of ambiguity, a lot of vagueness. The emphasis is on the meal rather than on the holy sacrifice. What doctrines are expressed clearly in the traditional Mass? Well, one is that Christ is God. In the traditional Mass, there are 11 genuflections. In the new Mass, there's three. Each genuflection is an act of faith in our Lord's divinity. Many priests in the new Mass who say the new Mass do not genuflect at all. A lot of little signs reflect our Lord's divinity more clearly than in the new Mass. Also, the idea of a sacrifice of Calvary, the idea of an unbloody sacrifice, of a propitiatory sacrifice, that Christ died for our sins, that's clearly expressed in the old Mass, much more clearly than in the new Mass. These are just a few things, and this time that we spend with you is not intended to be a study of the differences between the traditional Latin Mass and the new Mass, what is called the Novus Ordo. That's not our intention, but just to give you a few little background things of why we say the Mass. One question that might come into your mind, especially if you have not said the traditional Mass, you're a young priest, you're not coming back to it, you never said it, why Latin? Why not in the vernacular? Why not in the language of the country in which we exist? Well, very simple. The basic reason is to preserve the meaning of the doctrines in the Mass. Once you begin to translate it, then there's room for a lot of subjectivism, a lot of inexactitude. And in the United States, we use English. But how about in Africa, or in Asia, or in the Near East? There are hundreds of dialects and languages. It's an impossible task to translate this accurately. Now, in the medical profession, and in the legal profession even more so, they're so concerned about certain expressions that they retain their meaning. They never translate them. For example, habeas corpus. That's one example in the law, because you could go to Germany, France, Japan, and use the word habeas corpus. It means the exact same thing. But if that were translated, well, each country it would begin to take on a different meaning. So why Latin? First of all, to preserve the meaning of all the prayers, and to see that it's a fitting expression of Catholic doctrine. Also, the beauty of Latin, and also its universality. You can go any place in the world and hear the same exact Mass with the same exact prayers. Well, how do the people follow the Mass? Well, they use a missal. And it always was so. It takes a little effort to use the missal. One side is Latin, one side is English, or one side is Latin, one side is French, depending on the country in which you live. Although Pope Pius XII made it very clear that no one is obliged to follow the Mass by using the missal. It is the lay people, that is. Pope Pius XII made it very clear that you can participate in the Mass in any fitting and pious way. You can say the rosary, you can say your other prayers, use a prayer book, you can simply meditate, or, let's say, the ideal way is to follow the missal, but it's not necessary. If you participate in the traditional Mass, even though you may not say the prayers out loud, you are participating when you genuflect, when you stand, when you make the sign of the cross before the gospel, when you make the sign of the cross on your forehead, on your lips, and in your heart, when you fold your hands. All these are acts of prayers rather than verbalizing of prayers. So you do participate in the Mass by uniting yourself with Jesus Christ, who is the primary offer of the Mass. The priest is only the secondary minister. By offering yourself up and uniting yourself with Jesus Christ, who offers himself up on Calvary. Now, when we get into the actual ceremonies of the Mass, which we will in just a moment or two, the new Mass, those of you who say the new Mass, you will see that there's a structure, and the traditional Mass follows pretty much that structure. The bare bones of the Mass is there. We just have to, as they say, flesh it out. The differences between the traditional Mass and the new Mass, it's not simply the Latin. In a sense, that's one of the lesser differences. The prayers themselves, the offertory prayers have been changed, foot prayers have been changed. Many prayers in the canon have been changed. And even in the new Mass, the words of the consecration have been tampered with. In most American churches, when Christ, through the priest, leans over the chalice and says, "This is the chalice of my blood, the new everlasting covenant, which we shed for you and for many," promultus is translated in almost every American church as "for all" rather than "for many." So that's very inexact. A mystery of faith, which shall be shed for you and for many under remission of sins, after full formula of the consecration of wine. But in the new Mass, mysterium fidei, a mystery of faith, is removed from the formula and said after the consecration, and the priest says, "Let us proclaim the mystery of faith," and then the people say, "Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ will come again." So that's tampering with the formula also, because the mystery of faith is really the consecration. The mystery of faith is not "Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ will come again." Mysterium fidei is what happened at the Last Supper, that bread and wine were miraculously changed into the body and blood of Jesus Christ. At the Mass, it's very natural, the Mass, the traditional Mass. The bows, the movements are very natural. There's nothing artificial about it. Yes, there are several bows. There's a head bow, there's a head and shoulders bow, and there's a profound bow. It follows very naturally. And if at the beginning you don't do it exactly the way it's written in the liturgical books, don't worry about it. Just do the best you can. Also, as far as the voice is concerned, it's three levels of voice, and that is silence, and then very quiet, and then the next level is where, let's say, the altar boy can hear you, and the next level would be the people in the first row can hear you. Most of the Mass is said in the second one, and that is where the altar boy could hear you. But if you do not have a facility in Latin, then don't worry about pronouncing it loud, even for the altar boy to hear the altar servant. The main thing is that we say the Mass reverently, we pronounce the Latin the best we can, and little by little we'll obtain a facility there. So with that introduction, I'll conclude this part of it, and we'll begin the actual ceremonies of the Mass. And as we go along, I'll explain various things to you. Begin the Mass, we enter from the sacristy and walk up to the altar, bow to the cross, and we'll place the chalice down on the altar. Move over to the book. Now we'll be following the Mass of the Holy Trinity, which is the first Sunday after Pentecost. We'll open it to the feast of the Holy Trinity. Make an actual intention to unite yourself with Jesus Christ and offer up the holy sacrifice of the Mass in adoration to God the Father, sorrow for sin, thanksgiving, and petition. Bow to the cross, to the foot prayers, in the name of the Father, and Omnipotris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Now notice I'm holding a card with the foot prayers. I would recommend this to priests, certainly in the beginning, and even after you know the foot prayers by heart, it helps you to say them more slowly and to understand them. And Omnipotris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, Amen. Incredibo altar Dei, adem tu laetifica human to me. We continue down into the Confidio. Confidio Dei, cum detenti, beatum rius, virgin. The altar boy, we don't have an altar boy, and remember this is a simulated Mass, it is not a Mass, that's why I do not have on the vestments. The altar boy will then say the Confidio, and then when he finishes, we'll say Miseriata Vestri, Omnipotens Deus, et Dimisticatum Vestri, Sigitibus Vitam Eternum, Indulgentium, Absolution, et Remission, et Catonum Vestrum, Vobis Omnipotens, et Misericus Domus. Then these final few prayers, we bow slightly. Deus tu conversus vivificatus nos, et plebis tu vitamitur in te, et stain nobis domini misericordia in tua, et salutari tuum de nobis domine, exaudi orationem meam, et calma mea sancta venia, et dominus vobiscum, et spiritus tuum. Oremus. Walk up to the altar. We say quietly, Offer nobis quaesimus Domine, iniquitatis nostras, et sanctus sanctorum, pluris memoriam, omnibus inferior, et omnibus. Hands on the altar. Oremus se Domine, per mergens et fontum. Quorum reliquiae hic sunt, whose relics are here. That's what we say in the Latin. We kiss the cross with the altar. We kiss the altar where the relics are. To the Missal, make the sign of the cross, the introit, benedicta sit sancta trinitas, offering in divisa unitas. Say that to the end, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, glory be to Gloria Patri, et Filio, et Spiritus Sancto, secret erat in principio, et semper et saeculorum saeculorum, amen. And we repeat the first part of the antiphon, benedicta sit sancta trinitas, atque in divisa unitas, confitebimo e quia fecit obiscum. We say the Kyrie three times, Christe three times, Kyrie three times. If there's an altar boy or a congregation, we alternate them. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. If there's a glory in the Mass, as there is for the Mass of the Holy Trinity, we look up, elevatus oculis, it says, to elevate our eyes slightly and our hands. Gloria in excelsis Deo, we bow at Deo, and then we say, Gloria in terra pax omnibus, bona voluntatis, we can read it off the card. We bow our heads. Jesu Christi, Suscipe, and Suscipe de Picasso Nostrum. And then we continue to the end. Solitona, with all the wisdom of Jesu Christi, from Santo Spiritual and Glory Dei Patris Nomine.
Yes, on the altar.
Is the altar. Dominus Vobiscum, Spiritu Duo, response. Oremus, back to the cross. Hands extended, we say the oration. Omnipotens, that's the kind of prayer. We say this all the way through. If the name of Jesus comes into the reading, bow to the cross. If the name of the saint of the day, we bow to the book. For Domino Nostrum, this is the end of it. For Domino Nostrum, Jesum, Christum, Pilientum, we take and leave it at running out in the Tate Spiritus Sancta Deus, for Omnia, Stay, Lost, and Forum. Amen. Now, hands on the altar while we say the epistle, or on the book, either one. Lexio, Epistole, Diari, Pani, Apostoli, Ad Romanos. O Altitudo, Divitiarum, we read the epistle all the way to the end, and then we give a signal to the altar server by putting either our right or our left hand down. He knows that we're finished, he'll come up around. We continue reading the gradual. Benedictus says Domine, and then the Alleluia verse, Alleluia, Alleluia, Benedictus says. Then we go back over to the center, and we say the Mundacor and the Jube. Now, in the meantime, the altar server will move the book. Now, since I'm not using an altar server, I'll move the book myself. Now I'm back in the center, and I bow and say, the munda cor meam ac labia mea, cleanse my heart and my lips, Almighty God, as thou didst cleanse the lips of the prophet Isaiah with a burning coal of beautiful prayer. Then, Iube Domine Benedictere, grant, O Lord, a blessing to me that in corde meo, in my heart and my lips, I may worthily announce thy holy gospel. Amen. It's all done. And a beautiful prayer in preparation for the gospel. Dominus vobiscum, entum spiritu tuo, sequentia, first sign of the cross on the book, sequentia sancti evangelii, secunda matea, gloria tibi domine. In illo tempore dixit Jesus, this time I bow to the book. If the book is on a slant and the name of Jesus comes in, I bow to the book. If the book is facing straight, then I bow to the cross. So what I mean by having a natural movements in the mass, nothing awkward, nothing that's forced or unnatural. So it's natural for me to bow to the book when I say the holy name of Jesus, Dixit Jesus, Shibui Sui Stardes, Nibi Omnis Potestas, and Cello and Terra. We read that to the end. When it's finished, let me pick up the book, kiss it, beginning of the reading. Per Evangelica Dicta, through this holy words, may no faults be taken away. That's what it means. We move this back here. Because we're going to be using this quite a bit. Now the credo, the same as the gloria. We elevate our eyes and our hands slightly. Credo in nunum deum patrum omnipotentem, factorum celibitere, this building, omnium in this building. And in nunum domum Jesum Christum, bow the name of Jesus. And in carnatus este, spiritus sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. He was made man. Crucifixus etiam per nobis factus est et factus est. All the way down to the end. Et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum et victam venturi saeculi. Amen. Hands on the altar. Kiss the altar. Dominus vobiscum. Spiritus law. Oremus. Bow to the crucifix. Keep our hands folded, read the antiphon, offertory. Benedictus sit deus pater, unigenitus de filius sanctus corpus spiritus 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 spiritus. Now we'll fix the corporal. This could have been done, by the way, in the beginning of Mass at the same time and fix the book, or it can be done now. Usually, though, the priest will fix this in the beginning of Mass. Then we remove the chalice veil. offertory, one of the three essential parts of the Mass. We held a paten with a large host, about chest high. First of all, we glance up at the cross, and then back down, and look at the unleavened bread, and we say the offertory prayer. This is a very beautiful offertory prayer, as contrasted with a very weak offertory prayer. In the Novus Ordo, receive, O Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, this immaculate host, victim, hostia, means victim, which I and thine unworthy servant offer to thee, O my God, true and living, for my innumerable sins and offenses and negligences, and also for all those present, and for all the faithful departed, all the faithful, both living and departed, that to me and for them this sacrifice may contribute to their salvation and life everlasting. That's all said in the Latin. To make the sign of the cross and put the bread down, the bread. Now over to the side here, just a very little purification, very small. Ordinarily, the altar boy would hand me the cruet, so I put a little wine in, saying nothing, nihil dicens, and then we bless the water. Deus qui humanae substantiae, dignitate mirabilitae condicia mirabilis, like a musty, for a drop, and just a drop or two. Now, this signifies the union of the divinity of Christ and his humanity, the wine and water. And also, this is the way people did drink wine in those days. And we continue the prayer. Jesus Christus, Domus Nostrum, Dei Gloriosa, Glossa, Glorum, Amen. Now sometimes the priest will just remove some drops around here. He may or he may not do that. But we bring the chalice over about chest high, look up at the crucifix, and then down into the wine. Affirmus tibi Domine, we offer to thee, Lord, collegium solitaris, the chalice of salvation, to whom to the gods of Venetia, who in the spectre divinum I have stand astored for nostra, et osias mundi salute, and my glories for the damage. Sign of the cross over the corporal, place it down. We hold our finger. Whenever we put the paw back on the chalice, always place your finger on the base just to prevent an accident. Spiritual hands on the altar. And spiritual in tactus verna. Any sanctificata on the defense. Eternal days we call upon the Holy Spirit. Benedicat sacrificium tuo sancto nomine preparatum. Back over to the side for the purification of the fingers, the lavabo. The altar boy will place a little water on our fingers. We don't wash our whole hand. Lavabo inter innocentus manus meas et jucundum voluntari dum domine. We say that all the way down to the end. When we get to the end of that psalm, glory be to the Father, we bow to the cross, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. Gloria patria filio, et spiritu sancto, sigillare, 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 sigillare. Hands on the altar, then we look up at the cross, and we say, Succiave sancte trinitas. This is like a repetition of the offertory. Receive, O Holy Trinity, Concobatione, this offering, which we offer to thee in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, and Ascension of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Beautiful prayer. At the end of this, the priest, for the end of Christopher, must be brought in. This is the altar. Orate fratres, for name of Vestum Sacrificium, acceptable via Deum Patrum. Now we read the secret prayer. It's called secret because it's quiet. We say this aloud for the altar servant, Promia Secolas Secolorum. He answers, Amen. we turn to the preface. Our hands will be down on the altar. Dominus Lobiscum, Spiritus Duo, then Sorsum Corda. Lift up your hearts, that's what it means. Gracias a Gamas Domine Nostro. We read the preface, Veridima Justum Est, Ecum in Solitarius, keep it simpler. All the way down to the end, Una Voce Dicentes, now we bow as we say, Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus. The altar server rings the bell three times. We say, Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus. Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Plenius in Chile, a territory of Tua, Hosanna in Chelsis. Okay, straighten up. And let us remain in Nomen Domini, Hosanna in Chelsis. Over to the canon. Canon means law, fixed canon means a fixed law, and this is never to be changed. Te editura clementissimi pater, Jesum Christum Penitent. Subdit for them as a palus, now kiss the altar. Our hands together, yes, it's in the class, et dona. Our left hand should be off of the corporal, because after the consecration, when we bless, our hand would be on the corporal because our hand has touched the consecrated species. But for now, our hand will be slightly off the corporal as we make the sign of the cross with the right hand. Ek dona, this is over both together, over wine and the bread. Ek dona, ek munera, ek sancta sacrificia, and we extend our hands in primus, etc., etc. We pray, una cum famulo tuo papa nostro, that means together with tuo famulo, our brother, I guess, famulo, papa nostro, our pope, we mentioned his name, Pope John Paul, and artisti nostro, and then we mention the name of our bishop, and omnibus autodactus aquipitologi et apostolici divinis. Now this is memento of the living, so we move our hands together. Memento Domini famulorum, famulorum quae tuorum. And we pause antiquantum, it says in Latin, for a very short time, and we remember those living persons we wish to remember at Mass. We don't have to remember them all by name. People have asked us to pray for them. We can include them with an intention, all those people promise to pray for, or have asked us to pray for them, and also our other intentions. Okay, that only takes a very brief time, and should never be extended. Our own private devotion should never make the Mass too long. Always keep that in mind. Unless you're saying Mass by yourself, but if there's a congregation, then we should never enforce our piety on others. So, our pauses at the commemoration for the living and later on for the dead should always be reasonably brief. Come down to the end of that prayer, fold our hands, turn the page. The next prayer, communicantes, a memorial, we call upon all the saints. And that goes to the end, primum Christum Dominum Nostrum Amen. Now the priest is getting ready for the consecration, puts his hands like this over the wine and the bread, and the altar boy would ring the bell just once there to draw the people's attention to that. Hunc igitur, oblationem servitutis nostris, et ecum divinitatue, and so forth, per Christum Dominum Nostrum, upon the blessing Benedictum, and scriptum, gratum, making the sign of the cross over the oblata, that means the wine and the bread. Then, just over the bread, novus corpus, and then over the wine, and sanguis, fiat, Delightissimi filiato Dominus nostri Jesu Christi, our hands are joined. Now we're getting very close to the consecration. So we purify our fingers, which have been purified at the lavabo, but this is one final purification. We just rub them very easily all over the linen here, the corporal. We pray quam patirector accepit panem, it says in Latin. He accepted the bread, took the bread, so we take it, that check upon him. In Sanctus Ac Venerabilis Manus Suis, et Elevatus Oculis, we look up to the cross. In Cielo Montedeo Patrum Suo, Tibi Gratis Agens, a little bow, we say Tibi Gratis Agens, Benedixit, Fregit, Dique Tashibri Suis Dijens, Antibite, and Mandukate, Sapones. And our hands are on the corporal. And this altar's a little low, sometimes they're higher than this, but it doesn't make any difference. And we say the words. We're not saying mass, we're just simulating, so my intention is not to consecrate. And we say the words, hoc est anum corpus meum. It's genuflex. Elevation. The people usually will say in their hearts, my Lord and my God, the same words that St. Thomas said after the resurrection, when he realized that Christ was God, there's an indulgence in that prayer. And we place the consecrated host, genuflect again. Take the top off of the chalice. Purify with two fingers, just briefly. Simile modo post quantum non est. One hand at the bottom, one at the node. Accipiens et nunc placarum calcem sancta sanctus. Ethan tibi gratis agens, et bow again. Benedixit. Didique sheepli suis dicens accipite. Libite exeo omnes. Nec est enum calix omnis mei, novi et eternitas dementi. We go all the way through the words of consecration. Place the chalice down, we take the flight, in adoration. We say, hec posius cumque fecuritas in memoriam patientis. During that genuflection, elevation, long enough so that people can make an aspiration, an act of faith. Place the chalice, hold our finger on the base. Here, until our fingers are purified at the end of Mass, we should try to keep these two fingers together. That's an act of faith to do that. Unde et memoris Domini sui, servitui, sed et plestua sancta. And then we make the sign of the cross three times over the chalice and the consecrated bread. Hostiam puram, hostiam sanctam, hostiam regulatum. Supra quae propitio, continue that prayer to the end, and at the supplices, that's the next prayer. This time we profunde inclinatus, it says in Latin, that we profoundly incline with our hands on the altar. Supplices te rogamus, omnipotens Deus. Iube hic preferi promana sancti aut me tui in supplina autori tuum in conspectu divina maestatis tui. Quote, quote. That's where we kiss the altar. Ex apatos. Corpus, Son, Sum Servus, Omni, Benedictione, Celestia, Gratia, Requiem, Arcadium, Christi, so we make the sign of the cross. Over the sacred species, first over the bread, then over the wine, and then we make the sign of the cross ourselves. Now into the commemoration for the deceased. Memento etiam domine, from alarm, from alarum, quae tuorum, quinos precisem, cum signum fidei, et dormium, in somni pace. Was here. It says in Latin, ora aliquantum. He prays briefly. Ipsis Domine in omnibus in Christo, qui generis loci merit. Then here, when we say the Novus Corpus Pectoribus, we just say it a little louder because now we're praying for ourselves who are sinners. So it's a little louder. Novus Corpus Pectoribus. To us also sinners. Rest, of course, and then we continue along with the prayer. Fomulus tuis de multitudinibus restum informe. To the end, per Christum Domum Nostrum, per quem we join our hands, per quem hic omnia Domine supremum ambigas, sanctificas, vivificas, benedictus et praestas nobis. Our hand on the base, we move. Hold on to the chalice. Per ipsum, per ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso, est tibi Deo Patri omnis honor et gloria. And you notice the first three signs of the cross were over the wine, consecrated wine, and then between the priest and the chalice, twice. And then holding on to both together, we lift that up, omnis honor et gloria. Place the sacred host down, hold the base, put the top on. Hands folded, promia sacra. Promia secula secularum, amen. And we fold our hands. Oremus, projecta solitaribus moniti, divina institutione, comanda tenus dicere. This is the Our Father, Pater Noster, qui es in celis, sancti vicetum, amen. All the way down to the end, and they know some ducas in tentazione, and the altar boy responds, celebra nos amamo, and then we say quietly, amen. Now we're going to purify the pattern. Say the Libra. Libra nos quais in estomne, on nos modus of the churches. La propitius pacem debus nostris. Kiss the pen. And all things are clearly enjoyed, I believe. And I pass. Put the consecrated host onto the pen, onto the side. Take the top off of the Tecum vivit et regnat, filium tuum. Tecum vivit et regnat, caput spiritus sanctus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Pax Domini, sit semper, opus fin. Et tum spiritum tuum. We drop the small particle in, and we purify our fingers slightly. Put the top back onto the chalice and genuflect. We bow. Head and shoulders bow. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis patria. And we have a more profound bow as we put our fingers, our hands on the altar, and we say the three prayers, communion prayers, prior to receiving Holy Communion. Domine Jesu Christe. The next one is Domine Jesu Christe. And the third one is Progenitor Corpus Tui. Finish them, we stand erect, genuflect, and say, Panem Celestem Accipiam et Nomen Domini. I will accept the heavenly bread and I will invoke the name of the Lord. We bow slightly, Domini non sum dignus, the altar boy rings the bell three times. Domini non sum dignus. Domine non sum dignus. Okay. The sign of the cross. Remember, this is not a mass, but a simulated mass, so I'm not receiving the real body, but of our Lord. Focus on the Master Jesus Christ. This is a priest communion. The priest should swallow the Blessed Sacrament as soon as possible. We don't want this time to be protracted unnecessarily. After the Mass, there will be plenty of time for Thanksgiving. Now we remove the pall. Purify our fingers into the pattern. Just do a little bit of purifying of the corporal. Just a little bit, not too much. Never be scrupulous about that. It's more ceremonial than practical, although sometimes there might be some very evident particles. Pick up the chalice, corpus domini nostri Jesu Christi, custodium. Damn. Due time and time, and the sign of the cross, right? this point, we're going to give Holy Communion to the altar servers or to the congregational. This would be at the point where we would open the tabernacle and remove the ciborium. The altar boy would say the confidere. And the sometimes the altar boy does not. Says the liturgy according to 1962 or before, it's not a big problem or anything. But he says the confidere, you wait till that's over, and then the priest will turn around and get ready for give out Holy Communion. He'll say the Creator and the Angel Gentium, and he'll say Dominus and Dominus over the people, and then he'll see give them communion, get back here, put the ciborium back into the tabernacle, genuflect, and now we'll be back to where we are now. Okay, now the priest is going to purify the chalice, and he's going to purify his fingers. So he removes the pall, and he sips whatever little bit of the consecrated wine is left, and asks the altar boy to put some wine in. First purification is always wine, whether it's in his fingers or the chalice. So a little wine goes in first. Because in the order of things, the wine is a little more special than water. So the altar boy puts a little wine in there, and the priest says, Codor symptomus domi cormenti capianus et inquiri temporale fiendus. Again, goes back over. Now this time he's going to purify his fingers, and also at the second time give a second cleansing of the chalice, the wine on the fingers, and then a lot of water on the fingers. Since I have no altar server, I'll just put my two fingers in there, carry them over to here, and use the purification. I don't use the altar boy's finger towel. Because there may be on my fingers, there may be the remnants of the body of our Lord. So, having done that, there was a prayer that we say Corpus Domini Crucemisi. That's what I do, is just do it once like that, and then turn it inside out and do it once more. That's usually sufficient. The priest should not spend a long time purifying the sacred vessels, but he should give it a reasonable cleanliness. And then we'll put the child's veil. We can move this off to the side now. Accidental chance that it may somehow or other have one of the consecrated fragments on the ground. Now the altar boy in the meantime should move the book, so we shall do that. Hands folded for the communion verse, benedictions de incelia forum omnis eventibus capitatum et mea fecit custum et so on. Okay. This is the altar. Dominus vobiscum, spiritu tuo, oremus, proficiat nobis ad salutum corporis, so forth and so on, per domino nostrum deus in Christum tuum, we close the missal now. And incidentally, it's customary to close the missal with the open end facing the tabernacle crucifix. It seems to be liturgically correct. Domino nos vobisco, et in spiritu tuo, vitae missa est, et gratias. And we put our hands on the altar, we say this beautiful prayer, the flatula, may this be pleasing to the Holy Trinity, and so forth, flatula tibi, and we finish that, kiss the altar. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, pater, et filius, et spiritus sanctus. Dominus vobiscum. Spiritual Venetium, Sancti Evangelii, Secundum Ioannem, Gloria Tibi Domine. We make the first cross actually on the altar, and the other three, forehead, lips, and on the heart. And this beautiful prayer, beginning of St. John's Gospel, which is called the Last Gospel, which is really an act of thanksgiving. In the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God. It's actually a proclamation of our Lord's divinity in this Last Gospel. And we read it down to the end, sed ex Deo nati sunt, et verbum caro factum est, and the Word was made flesh, et habitat in nobis divinus, quorum meus, quorum quasi divinitur, a pater plena gratia veritatis. And we bow to the cross, and we're going to kneel down and say the prayers after Mass. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus, Holy Mary, Mother of God. Pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death. Amen. There's three Hail Marys. These are called the Leonine Prayers because they were mandated by Pope Leo in the late 1800s. And they're really prayers for peace. Then Hail Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, we say that all the way through. Pray for us, the Holy Mother of God, we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Our hands are folded during this. Let us pray, O God, our refuge and our strength. Look down with favor upon thy people at the end of that. And then the prayer of St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against mouths and snares of the devil. Restrain him, O God, we humbly beseech thee, and to thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power. Thrust into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Having done that, then the priest may leave the chalice on the altar and just retire to the sacristy, or he may pick up the chalice, bow to the cross, and then he may retire. If the Blessed Sacrament is present, then he would genuflect at the bottom of the stairs of the altar before he goes back in. So I'll put the chalice back where we began, and that takes us to the end of the Mass prayers. I hope we made it as simple as possible for you, and a little bit at the end of this table, put down the names of some books that you could obtain, and the source of these books to help you understand the Mass a little better. May God bless you all.